Genesis chapter 8. I'm going to start reading at verse 6. Now, anybody know the story of Noah's Ark? Come on, I said, do you know the story of Noah's Ark? This story, it means that God is separated. That God is separated. That God is calling for separation of certain things. Perhaps of what is unacceptable, which is what God was doing here. That he was now causing there to be a separation from the acceptable to him and the unacceptable to him. Water is a sign of separation. So whenever God uses water, he's trying to separate. Say separate.
Separate.
When God was trying to cause their separation,
until Jesus and John the Baptist are in the water, when John was getting ready to separate Jesus, saying that he is different from all the others. He is not like all the men. They were in the water.
Watch this. God could have taken Israel over the land when they was leaving Egypt. He took them through the water. But he didn't separate. He had to take them through the muddy waters. Perhaps through the deep waters. Right? He had to take them through the water. Why? Because he was causing for there to be separation. They were getting ready to get over into the promised land. No, they had to, they couldn't build no bridge. They had to go where? In the book of Revelation, the Bible tells us that there were some demons trapped under the river Euphrates. Jesus. And watch this. The demons couldn't get out because there was water over them. Because it is not in their makeup that they can handle water. You remember that now that the demons who were there acting a fool, and it was chaotic and people ain't know what to do. They probably be scared. And Jesus said, hold it. And the demons got to begging Jesus. They said, wait. At least let us go to the swine.
Yes.
The demon. And when the demons started going after the pigs turned and ran to the water. Because even the pigs knew that demons cannot swim. So next time your circumstance tries to bring you down, next time the ravens try to bring down your spirit, you just go to the water. Out of your belly. So then when praise now comes forth, it separates. Ooh. It separates good from evil. Come on. It separates the sheep from the goats. Come on now. It separates the truth from lies.
Yes.
Out of your belly shall flow rivers of living water. God uses water to separate. But he designed you and created you to allow it. Rivers of living water.
Yes.
You ain't got to change your locale. You don't have to walk away to another room. Just get to say, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Yes.
Lord, you're worthy. Yes. I give you the honor. And watch that raven go from to from. Last thing.